A promising young talent with a lot of swagger.
The following contest is a no-holds-barred match. Making his way to the ring from Boston, Massachusetts, weighing in at 210 pounds, Carmelo.
I hate to parrot a catchphrase, but Mello really is money.
Multiple title reigns and main events to his name already.
And this guy is destined to continue that success in all of WWE.
The Alpha Academy is open for business.
We're about to see a clinic.
And his opponent, representing the Alpha Academy from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 202 pounds, Chad Gable!
Chad may be the greatest coach of all time. Look what he did to Otis.
Yeah, but is Chad Gable actually teaching the right lessons?
Look at the record book, Saxton. You see all those W's? Those look like the right lessons to me.
Great tag team. There's been some discussion about what exactly a no-holds-barred match means. Corey, what's your take on it?
Just a fancy way of saying you can do whatever the hell you want. As long as you pin or submit the other competitor in the ring, go nuts, which is exactly what I predict these superstars will be doing momentarily. Oh, a tiebreaker!
Boom! Bicycle knee strike.
Oh, good job.
Boom! He was elusive there.
Flipped upside down there.
Able to elude it.
Penny predicament. And only a one count.
Seems a little too early in this match to go for the pin.
No disqualifications has to benefit a certain type of superstar more than others, doesn't it, Corey?
Get off your high horse, Cole. A no disqualifications match benefits the superstar who's smarter, faster, and better. Using the rules to your advantage doesn't make you the villain here.
And he's able to reverse. And did you hear the impact of that?
Incoming!
Heads out, and he has all the time he wants.
Stuff and go.
Keep it in the ring, please. Saxton's a very fragile boy.
Perhaps looking for some kind of equalizer here.
If you're going to grab a kendo stick, you better be prepared to use it. Gable's pushing back now.
But he still has more work to do to get this fully in his favor.
That puts a stop to Gable.
Gable is waiting for it.
And we just saw some serious offense.
Saxton, they're too busy beating the tar out of each other.
And Hayes turning it around.
Well-placed punch, ugly, but effective response.
Back and forth from these competitors.
And he said, you're not getting me with that this time.
Clearly waiting for that.
Carmelo putting it on the line.
Off the top.
Good Lord, taking flight.
And that was a collision you don't want to be on the receiving end of.
Came down like a wrecking ball on a cinder block.
Gable avoids that one.
Showing some extra scouting, knowing how to answer a counter with a counter of your own.
He's certainly lining him up, but he's wasting too much time.
Oh.
Averting danger with an elbow to the stomach.
Uh-oh, ankle pick. Beautiful takedown. Oh, knee crusher.
That's gonna hurt.
Boot to the gut will stop anyone in their tracks.
He returns to the ring,
and his eyes are piercing through the opposition now. Look at this!
Oh, man. It's like a heat-seeking missile coming at you.
And the explosion occurring ringside. Stalking him. Watch.
Set up for a second time.
Not what Hayes intended.
Gable might be waking up.
Gable tipping the scales a bit here.
And an impactful display of offense we just witnessed there.
Ooh.
What could Chad be looking for?
Skirts around it. Double under hook. Into the powerbomb.
He's struggling a bit here.
Yeah, as Gable once again proving just how effective the teachings of Alpha Academy can be.
Up across the shoulders.
Here it comes. Tiebreaker.
Finish it off.
Chad went from ready, willing, and Gable to ready,